Welcome out, ladies and gentlemen, to West Lawrence High School. We're here with head coach Kegan McLean. Coach McLean, we went on the road last week to Mary Persons. It's always tough when you go on the road with Mary Persons. I don't care if you play Mary Persons at home or somewhere in between, in the middle of a cow pasture. It's going to be tough, isn't it?
That's right, definitely.
Yeah, so, okay, you had your game plan put together. You look at film. And you try to see how fast these kids are and how tough they are, and then you show up Friday night and you get out there in the very first play. Tell us about what happened.
Well, you know, you come out, and it was actually the second play they scored on. But, you know, you know Mary Persons are going to be fast, going to be physical, just playing them year in, year out. We've played them every year since I've been here as a region opponent. And again, they're a well-coached team. They always have athletes. You know, they have big kids, and they're tough. And we had some wars with them the past few years. And, you know, we went up there, and right off the bat, they come out in the second play. They break a big run on us, hit us in the mouth, and score. Then I go up 7-0. And I felt like, as has happened several times this year, our kids did a good job of making adjustments, of getting back into the game. Right. We fought back right before halftime. It's 14-9. Mm-hmm. We have fought back into it. And then we give up a kickoff return down to, like, our 10-yard line.
Yeah.
And it's tough to keep a good team out from the 10. And they punched in and went up 21-9. And after that second half, we really shut them down completely the second half until late in the game. We fumbled it inside our 20, and they punched one in late to kind of put the icing on the cake.
Yeah.
But it was a physical game. Their kids were athletic. Their kids were fast. I thought our kids fought hard and played well at times. We didn't play our best game defensively for sure.
Yeah.
But our kids played hard, made good adjustments, and I felt like our coaches made good adjustments on the sideline.
Yeah.
And we were able to get ourselves in a position to be back in the game. Mm-hmm. We just weren't able to get over that hump and pull out a victory.
Yeah, and coach, you know, you want to be positive with the kids. You want to show them the good things they did. But in looking at the game and their, you know, defensively, they had some faster kids than us. They beat us sometimes on the outside. They, mm-hmm. you know, they blocked a little bit better than we did. Mm-hmm. You know, there are things that you look at, you got to analyze, you got to try to get better at. But speed of kid, you want to.
Definitely, and it's the thing that coaches say, you can't coach speed. You know, either you got it or you don't.
Yeah.
And they had it. And you know, we're not super fast, but we try to make up with, you know, for that by being tenacious mm-hmm. and swarming to the football.
Mm-hmm.
And went back and looked at it, and every big play they had, we had an unblocked player in position. He just wasn't able to make a play.
Yeah.
And sometimes it comes down to just make the play. If you're unblocked and it's you one-on-one, get a hand on him, hang on, grab mm-hmm. on, and mm-hmm. give time for your brothers to get there and finish the deal. Mm-hmm. And we weren't able to do that Friday, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But, you know, when you look at trying to find positives out of it.
Yeah.
You know, every drive they started on their side of the 50, they scored 7 points all night. When they started on our side of the 50, they scored 21. So field position's a huge thing.
It's everything, isn't it?
Yeah, and we did not do a good job in the field position game. Not that our special teams were that bad other than the kickoff. But we just weren't able to move the ball and flip the field very much.
Coach, you know, in looking at defense, you know, and I love defense. You obviously love defense. And I like to be physical. I like for that line to get in there. And Q-Mac, I thought, did a pretty good job. Abram, having him back.
Abram helped a lot.
Hey,
yeah.
Man, that yeah. kid is fast. You forget how fast, how quick he is, and how big he is, how right. he's able to move up and down that line.
Yeah.
So I thought it was good to have him back.
Definitely.
That's a positive factor.
And you know, we played – pretty much the whole game without Dorian Gorham, our leading tackler on defense.
Yeah.
You know, he tweaked his ankle last week at practice, and he tried to play, and he was just hobbling around out there, and mm-hmm. he was begging to stay in, and we just had to pull him. I mean, he wasn't helping us, number one, because he was so
– Couldn't get there.
Couldn't get there. And then number two, you know, he's just going to make it worse out there running on him, and our season yeah. didn't hinge on one game.
Right.
So, you know, we had to pull him out, and we're looking at today. It was good having Abram back,
yeah.
but you know we really
but you traded Gorham.
Yeah, we haven't been at full strength on the defensive side since the scrimmage game this year. We've had so many injuries, you know, and that's not an excuse, not an excuse at all. The teams that beat us have beat us. They've earned it. They've outplayed us, and they've beat us. And I tip my hat to them for that. But it would be nice to have a game where we've got all 11 starters healthy and getting after it. And we just hadn't had that. And hopefully, you know, Dorian may be out again this Friday. Yeah. He's questionable. We lost Trent Carr, mm-hmm. outside linebacker. He's got a sprained LCL in his knee, so he probably won't play Friday. Hopefully, we'll be back for Perry, our starting running back and leading rusher. Dorian Edmonds, severely sprained ankle also during the game. He's going to be out probably the next 2 weeks. Maybe could be back for Perry. If not, be back if we can inch our way into the playoffs. You know?
Yeah.
So we're definitely beat up right now. And you know, you can hang your hat or hang your head and be upset and say, well, you know, these guys out, what are we going to do? Woe is me. Or the next guy can step up and say, you know what, I'll fill in. Mm-hmm. I'll make the play. And the guys that are in there can say, you know, I'll do double the work to make up for my brother who can't do the work. Mm-hmm. And those are the kind of things we got to have if we're going to win Friday.
Yeah, that's right, Coach. We're going to take a short break, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to be back to talk about who the next man up on the West Lawrence Raider team is. So stay tuned.
At Bank of Dudley, we want to help with all your lending needs. Whether you're thinking of buying a new car, remodeling your home, or just want to go on vacation, let one of the many lenders at a Bank of Dudley branch near you help realize your dreams. Bank of Dudley, we're big enough to offer the great services you need, but small enough to make sure you can talk to someone you trust. Bank of Dudley with five convenient locations, East Dublin, Downtown Dublin, and Veterans Boulevard, Dudley, and Jeffersonville. Bank of Dudley, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
In 2011, we had a really bad snowstorm, and we were out of power for 6 days, and we couldn't find a hotel to go to that would accommodate the family and the dog. We lost hundreds of dollars worth of steak and hamburgers and things like that that we had in our freezer downstairs. And once Hurricane Sandy hit in this area, it was very, very traumatic for everybody. But thanks to the Generac 20 kilowatt generator that we have, we barely noticed it. We have heat, we have air conditioning, we have all of it. The world around us was very chaotic, but in our home, we felt very safe and secure. I'd be more than happy to buy it again. You know, it's one of the best investments I've ever made in this house.
Don't ever get caught in the dark again. Call the City of Dublin Natural Gas today. 0% financing and we'll just add it to your bill. The City of Dublin Natural Gas, the smart choice.
We treat patients from general cardiology to interventional cardiology. I implant pacemakers, defibrillators, I do catheterization, stenting, I do every aspect of cardiology, including nuclear cardiology. We're available. Most of the time you don't really need a referral. Most of the time you can call and we can usually work you in and see you and do the appropriate treatment. I have patients that come in and I frankly talk them out of any testing. I say, why would you want to waste $2,000 to $3,000 worth of tests when the yields are going to be nil to none and it's very unlikely you have what you think you have. And that's just being a professional. And I think most physicians should be professional and that's essentially how I always gear my way of practicing. I don't have a mission statement, but my statement is go through life and touch people positively and make a difference in somebody else's life. And that's how I practice, and that's how I live.
Hi, I'm Christy Sims with Barry Walker Insurance Agency right here in Dublin, Georgia, your nationwide agent. I've spent the last 18 years at Geico Insurance in Macon, and I am so glad to be serving you here and all the people in Dublin. No matter what you need, I'm here to serve you with any of your insurance retirement needs, from your auto to your homeowners to your boat, RV, motorcycle, or pet. That's right, folks. Nationwide has been helping pet owners provide optimal veterinary care since 1982. So call me now, and I'll work hard to make sure that you and your family and all your pets are covered. I'm Christy Sims, and I want to work for you. Always remember, Nationwide is on your side.
All right, welcome you back, ladies and gentlemen. Again, out at West Lawrence High School, we're talking football with head coach Kegan McLean. And Coach McLean, 2-1 in the region is not that bad.
No.
Ups and Lee, your next team. And I heard you tell the team Friday night after the game was over, look, the season's not over. Don't start hanging your head thinking, right, hey, this is it. Our season's over. Far from it. It's one loss in the region.
That's right.
And all those games, I don't care. You know, you look up and down the schedule. You look in any region. You look at any play. Nothing matters until you get to competition, true competition in your region, in your playoff, and no matter at what level.
That's right.
So, you know, Coach, when we look at that and we're going on forward for Ups and Lee and we look at where we are with Dorian coming out of the backfield, with maybe Dorian Gorham, you know, being out on defense, with other injuries. There are a couple more that we got to be concerned about.
That's right.
So let's talk about who's going to be in that backfield for us and what they're bringing, how old they are.
Well, our running back will kind of be by committee this week. The guy that will step in and start will be Shante Burney. He's a 10th grader. He's played some this year. Got some carries in the Warner Robins game and some other games when Dorian came out.
Not a bad looking kid.
No, he's a good tough runner. Not a big kid. He's smaller in stature again. Mm-hmm. Only a 10th grader.
Mm-hmm.
But he runs hard. He's got some speed. Got some quickness, definitely a shifty kid mm-hmm. in there, and he's going to have to tote more of the load this week. Mm-hmm. Got a couple other young guys, sophomore Christian Coven, will be carrying the ball a little bit. Mm-hmm. And there may even be a couple other guys, depending on what we have to do. We may have to get in a little more wildcat stuff and do some things out where maybe throw the ball. We're going to have to do what we got to do
right.
to move the chains
right.
and try and get the ball in the hands of guys who can make plays. Mm-hmm. But I think Shante will do a good job for us. Mm-hmm. He's had a good week of practice. He's a good kid, works real hard, and I think that he'll be able to step in and do well. On the defensive side, stepping in for Dorian, Isaiah White, who played the Wayne County game when De'Eric was hurt. Mm-hmm. He's kind of been our backup guy yep. all year at linebacker. Mm-hmm. And he's a good linebacker. He's yeah. a smaller kid too, but he plays hard. He's physical. He knows what to do. He's been in our program for 4 years, so he knows the defense in and out. He'll be fine. And he may not bring quite the physicality that yeah. Dorian brings,
yeah.
But he can run. He's fast. He's smart. Mm-hmm. He'll do a good job there. And at outside for Trent Carr, Romello Heights been getting the reps this week. Romello's a sophomore, but he's a big, tall, a physical kid who's a little behind the learning curve. He missed a good bit this summer, but has come in and has really worked to catch up. And once he learns and the light clicks on, he's going to be a really, really good player for us. So he's going to step in, and he's had a good week of practice too, and I think he'll do a good job for us at that outside linebacker spot.
All right, Coach, let's back it back up just for a second, if you don't mind,
sure.
Talking about offense. Okay, the line, they'll have a real good game. They'll have a good series, might fall off a little. And again, you got real physical guys up front this past week, so you got to take that into consideration. Sure. You got to take into consideration, Coach, most times they line it up, and linebackers were coming off the snap mm-hmm. for right. Mary Person, so you got to think about that as well. But how does your line look this week, and who are we going with?
Well, it's pretty much going to be the same guys. Miguel Butler will probably get the start at that right guard position. Miguel started the week before.
How's he coming along?
He's coming along. He's learning. You know, he's been a D lineman most of the year.
Yeah.
And he did practice with the offense, and he's been learning a little offense.
There's a lot to learn on
there's
offense.
Playing offensive line's tough.
It's
the toughest position on the field.
You not only have to be tough, you got to be smart.
You got to be smart. And you're doing that dirty work that you're not going to get the big recognition for. The people that know football know that the line's where it's at.
Yeah.
But you know, your casual fan's not gonna be knowing the names of those offensive linemen out there. Yeah. But Miguel's going to do a good job in there, I believe. He's a very physical kid. He's a junior. You know, he'll be a starter for us on the O-line next year in all likelihood. Mm-hmm. And it's great that he's getting these reps.
Right.
And once he learns what to do, he's going to be fine in there too. Mm-hmm. And the rest of the other four will be the same. You know, we just got, you know, we got outmatched a little bit last Friday. Their D-line just whipped us up front, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
And we didn't do a good job of staying on blocks and running our feet and hitting back. You know, sometimes you get hit in the mouth and you got to turn, you got to hit them back.
That's right.
And a couple times I felt like we got hit and we didn't fight back the way I wanted us to.
Yeah, Coach, that's imperative. You know, people have to look at that. Obviously, football is an extremely physical game, and you're going to get punched in the mouth.
Yep,
there's no doubt about it. It's just what you're going to do once you get punched in the mouth, because it's going to happen 9 out of 10 games.
That's right.
Somebody up and down that line, somebody in the backfield, they're going to get hit pretty hard. And you got a man up. You got to want it back. And,
that's right.
You know, when we look at – we get down inside the 20 and we get to that heavy set this week, what are we going to do in the backfield if Gorham's not able to go? What will you do there?
Hopefully I can maybe go to Walmart and pick up another running back.
Coach, I don't think that's going to work.
I don't know if Shante will do it. He'll be fine. But we'll put the big boys in front of him.
Yeah.
And they'll block and he'll find a crease and he'll be okay.
Mm-hmm.
He'll
yeah.
be okay in
yeah.
that. But, you know, it's just part of making adjustments. I mean, you know, in years past, we hadn't had a lot of injuries. We've been fortunate. Mm. Other than Darius Bradford, obviously going down was a big one for us.
Oh, yeah.
But this year, we've just had a lot of little nagging things that have kept a kid out of game here, a game there.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes football's that way.
Yeah.
I've been on teams you go the whole year, never have any injuries. And I've been on teams where everybody's hurt every week.
Yeah, somebody's hurt every single week.
So,
and, Coach, a lot of times you got to find that kid, and some kids are a little bit better. Some people are. At a little bit better at working through pain
that's
throughout
right.
the course of a day or through the game.
Yep.
You know,
yep.
you got to play hurt sometimes in football.
You know,
it's that time of year.
Yeah, we preach it. We say, look, there's a huge difference in being hurt and being injured.
All right.
If you're hurt, it's uncomfortable, but you can go and you can help your team.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you're injured, you don't need to go for your sake and for your team's sake.
Mm-hmm.
But some kids don't know the difference in being hurt and injured. And that's a year-to-year thing, because high school football, people don't realize, you know, some of them don't, that you have a completely different team every year. You know, you lose guys to graduation, new guys come in, and there's a few holdovers, but the whole makeup of the team is different.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like college, you can go out and you recruit and fill those positions.
Right.
You got to play with who walks through those doors,
mm-hmm.
and you got to fit them in the best spots you can.
Mm-hmm.
And some years you're a little better at some things, some years a little better at others, some years you're a little tougher, And some years you got to build that up. Mm-hmm. And we're in the process now of kind of rebuilding some of that tough mentality. And our kids are doing a good job with it. They're mm-hmm. playing tough.
But you got to build that, don't you, Coach?
Yeah, we got a lot of young kids. I mean, you heard me talk about a lot of sophomores are going to be playing.
Right.
And you know, when you're a sophomore and you've only been in the weight room one full year, you know, you haven't quite built that toughness yet.
Yeah.
But they're getting there. And we're going to keep preaching that, and we're going to keep pounding that football stuff. Tell people it's kind of like the military. It's not for everybody, but it's necessary.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Everybody can't crack it. Yeah. In that, it's not for everybody, but the ones who can, you gotta get on their shoulders, and you gotta ride those guys, and they gotta make it happen for you.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. I mean, I would rather have 60 kids who are gonna go to war and be tough and be physical and that you can count on than have 115 on your roster and a lot of cancers and a lot of guys you can't depend on.
Yeah.
And we've got good kids this year, and I'm proud of them.
Well, Coach, you know, you look at it from a coaching standpoint, you look at it from a program standpoint. 10th graders, you know, at the end of the season, having to play, stepping up, you got to look at the silver lining in the cloud. I mean, that's going to help you in days and weeks to come, especially
doubt.
If it clicks.
Yeah, because a lot of those guys are going to be starters next year. And Friday night experience is invaluable. Doesn't matter how much JV you play, doesn't matter how much ninth grade you play, until you get under those Friday lights and you get in that fire, you don't really know what it's like. And you're not ready for it.
Yeah.
And they're getting a
10th grader going against a 12th grader.
That's tough.
It's tough.
That's
10th grader going against a year at that age makes a big difference in
a
kid.
Well, there's a huge difference in a 15-year-old and a 17 or 18-year-old.
Yeah.
Physically, there's a huge difference.
Mm-hmm.
And people don't realize that you may be big as a 10th grader, but you're still a 15-year-old,
right.
and your body ain't developed like that 17, 18-year-old kids has, and you got to really, and it's a process, you know.
Yeah.
And so, great experience for these guys. Mm-hmm. It's going to be beneficial for us next year, but we need them to step up, and make some plays this Friday too.
Yeah, yeah. Now, Coach, we talk about this Friday. We're going to take a short break, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to break down a little bit about Upson Lee, and we'll be back with that in just a moment. So stay tuned here on the West Lawrence Raider Coaches Show.
Allen's Heating and Air is your licensed Amana equipment dealer. Trust Allen's Heating and Air to install and service your heating and air conditioning unit. Allen services all brands. With the purchase of a new Amana unit, you'll get a lifetime warranty on the compressor. Allen's Heating and Air. Call Sean Clark or any of his friendly staff at Allen's Heating and Air. Amana Heating and Air Conditioners. Last and last and last.
At Bank of Dudley, we want to help with all your lending needs. Whether you're thinking of buying a new car, remodeling your home, or just want to go on vacation, let one of the many lenders at a Bank of Dudley branch near you help realize your dreams. Bank of Dudley, we're big enough to offer the great services you need, but small enough to make sure you can talk to someone you trust. Bank of Dudley with 5 convenient locations, East Dublin, Downtown Dublin, and Veterans Boulevard, Dudley, and Jeffersonville. Bank of Dudley, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Join Piggly Wiggly in the celebration of our 100th anniversary, and the celebration is spreading throughout our community with a renewed pride in our hometown grocer, Piggly Wiggly. 100 years of great product and great customer service. Piggly Wiggly is where you'll find everything from the freshest in produce to 100% certified Angus beef, the only certified Angus beef dealer in Lawrence County. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street. Thanks for joining us in our 100th anniversary celebration.
All right, welcome you back, ladies and gentlemen. Now, we want to talk about the game ahead. You know, we've talked about the injuries we've faced. We've talked about some issues that we're going to face and some adjustments that we're going to be making. But when it comes down to Upson Lee, who do they have back that we can compare to what we saw last year as far as that speed?
Yeah, well, they've got a lot of their skill guys back. The running back number 10 is back, and he had a good game against us last year.
Yeah.
They did lose the quarterback, but the kid they got at quarterback is very athletic, very similar to the kid they had last year. They bring back 2 offensive linemen. They graduated 3. They bring back 1 of their quick receivers is back, and they got a couple other new guys out there who are good-looking kids. They're going to be very similar to Mary Persons. I wouldn't quite put them on the same level as Mary Persons, but I wouldn't really put anybody in our region quite on that level.
Usually don't.
But they're a very good football team. They lost up at Mary Persons by 7. Played them very tough when they were up there. They're going to be one of the biggest teams we play. They got really good size on the lines and at linebacker.
Mm-hmm.
They look like us in a lot of ways, with a few more weapons on the offensive side.
Mm-hmm.
But it's going to be a tough game. And they do a lot of good things on offense. They're, again, a very well-coached team.
They run out of a lot of sets still?
Ton of formations. A lot of motions, a lot of trading, a lot of option in their game. So you got to be really sound in assignment discipline. Mm-hmm. You got to be good at that.
Take the first man coming.
That's right. And you got
to
know.
It's hard to get that on a kid if you hadn't faced that.
That's right.
Coach
Junior. Right.
Now, if you faced it or if your mm-hmm. offense runs an option type,
right.
You know, then it's not as right. difficult. But, man, you get out there and you hadn't faced that coach. You want to take, here he comes, he's going to pitch it, I know, and you want to take the second man. You can't do that.
That's right. And it's a lot of the RPO stuff where they're running the zone inside and the quarterback's got the option of pulling it, keeping it, or throwing it.
And he does.
And he does all three of them. You got to have some discipline. You got to know your assignment, mm-hmm. and you got to swarm to the football so that we don't get those one-on-ones out mm-hmm. there in space. Mm-hmm. And that's why option's such a great thing. And you know, option's been around football forever. In various forms, and it'll be around forever
because it
puts you in one-on-one situations.
Yes.
It makes you be really, really sound mm-hmm. on defense. And you can't replicate it with your scout team. You know, you can do the best you can, but you're not going to replicate the speed
nope.
and the execution
nope.
all week. You know, so what you try and do as a coach is you try and put all year long and all summer long elements of the option in what you're seeing so that you're getting a little bit of work at it mm-hmm. every week. Because if you mm-hmm. don't see any of it and then they throw it at you on Friday, you know, yeah. Georgia Tech makes a living. You know, with lesser athletes
right.
Beating teams that can't prepare in a week for that mm-hmm. stuff. And this isn't a Georgia Tech option. It's a spread option. But it's still similar philosophy, similar concepts.
Sure. Okay, so who would you say for Upps in the league is the strongest one and two? Running back, strongest player?
Yeah, I think the running back and the quarterback really make the offense go.
Yeah.
They've got that big tight end back, big number 44 and number 9 also that play tight end and defensive end. And they're just huge kids, and they get their hands on you. They're tough. Mm-hmm. But that offense is really, really predicated on number 2, the quarterback, and number 10, the running back. Mm-hmm. When their game's on and they're doing their thing, you know, they're tough to stop. And they've scored on everybody. You know, no one's really completely just shut them down this year. You know, even in region play, you know, they scored 21 on Persons. You know, they put 38 on Perry. I mean, they've scored points, you know.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a tall order for us, mm-hmm. Even though we're not at full strength. You know, I don't want that to be an excuse. I want our kids to go out and get after it, and I believe they can, and we're going to play hard, and hopefully we'll make enough plays to win the game.
Yeah, and we've talked about the difference in what we got on the defensive unit. So mm-hmm. you might have to mix it up a little, Coach. You
yeah.
might have to, you know, stunt a little more. What?
Yeah. Sometimes you got to take some chances. You know,
yeah.
sometimes when you're – if you can't, and my philosophy always, if I can stop you in my base defense, I'm going to play base defense.
Right.
But if I can, I got to make adjustments. You know?
Yeah.
I don't like to go in a game saying I'm going to do all this stuff.
Yeah.
You know, I like to go in there saying, let's see if I can stop you.
Yeah.
If I can stop you,
nose
great. If
to
I
nose,
can't,
yeah. let's see.
You know, if I can't, then I got to make an adjustment.
Right.
It's just easier on the kids when they can learn their assignment, learn their responsibility without having 9 or 10 different things to learn. You know,
mm-hmm.
you don't want paralysis by analysis out there. I'm thinking so much they can't run.
Yes, sir. Okay, so secondary is healthy.
Yes, for the most part, yes. Secondary, we're healthy.
Okay.
That's one part we're healthy.
Yes, sir. Okay, and it's going to take it because of the option, because of the amount they throw.
Right.
Of course, you know, you got linebacker coverage there that's going to have to pick up because
oh, yeah.
they throw that short pass.
Yeah, definitely. You know, our outside linebackers are going to be very, very disciplined, especially Ben Deal to his side. He's going to have to be very disciplined at reading his keys, checking that quarterback, and doing his job.
Mm-hmm.
And if he does that and he breaks down and makes tackles, mm-hmm. I think we'll be okay, you
mm-hmm.
know. And we got to fill inside and stop the zone. And the secondary guys got to pick up all the RPO stuff.
Yeah.
And, you know, if we do a good job of that, we'll be fine. If we don't, if we're out of position, then they're going to have a good night on us.
Yeah. You know, Coach, so many times you look at it and you could say, gosh, if we can just get penetration in that backfield, that changes the whole game.
Oh, no doubt. You're playing any kind of option team, whether it be zone option or your traditional option. If you can get penetration, especially in those inside gaps,
mm-hmm.
You know, it messes with that mesh point a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what we got to have. We got to have some guys penetrate inside, get off blocks, and make tackles. You know,
mm-hmm.
it can't be that thing. We can't be block magnets. We can't stick to them.
Yeah.
You know, we got to get off blocks and make plays. Just because one guy's on you don't mean you can't throw shed and get out there and make a tackle.
Mm-hmm.
And we got to be good at that this week.
Yeah, Coach, with Abram coming back in, we didn't see Dacus.
Right.
We didn't see him. I don't know if you're going to float him in and out or if it's just an option this week. But when Morrow came back in, man, it was like the light came on in that position.
Right.
You know, he's
Absolutely.
Just such an incredible kid.
And Dacus has done a great job for us.
No doubt.
Dacus will probably be a defensive line starter next year.
Yeah.
And he may get some reps this week at end,
mm-hmm.
you know, some, depending on how the game's going and some things we're doing.
Sure.
But, you know, Dacus is only a sophomore.
Right.
You know, again, he's a young kid.
And he's light.
And he gets after it in the weight room. He's going to be a really, really good
mm-hmm.
football player. And it's been great that he has stepped up this year. And when Abram went down, Dacus stepped in, and we still won some games.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I tell people, you know, despite all our adversity, and again, those aren't excuses. I mean, teams that beat us have beat us. But despite all the adversity, we've struggled. We're only one game different than we were last year, and that's the Wayne County game. Mm. You know, last year we beat Wayne, this year we didn't.
Yes.
But all the other games, we're right there on par with where we were last year. And that may be a little different. We're not quite as dominant on defense.
Sure.
But we're still giving up 15 points a game.
Yeah.
I mean, that's not
But like
that's
you
not
say,
awful.
I make that comparison to people as well. You look at last year's record, you look at this year's record. You know, it's what you do from here on out. It's all about region play, and you lost one region game.
And you look at the teams that beat us. I look at their records. I think – you know, combined the three, the four losses we have, they're like 25-3 or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And those three losses were to Lee County, Glenn Academy, and Peach. So you know, it's not like we've gotten beat by some bad teams. Some good teams have beat us. And, and again, I want to be able to beat those good teams. And unfortunately, we haven't been able to do that this year. You know, or hopefully, we're building a program up where we can year in year out, you know, be like Mary Persons, be like some of those schools, and beat those good teams every year.
But it takes a lot of work, Coach. It takes the right coaching staff. It takes a lot of support from the community.
Time. It takes time. People don't understand. You know, Coach Noble's really laid a great foundation with this weight room, and we were able to really get in here and get after it. And if you have a great program, even when graduation hits you, you can compete. And graduation hammered us last year.
Yep.
We lost 15 starters. But we're still competing because we've got a program in place. And I give credit to Coach Nobles for starting that and letting me be a part of it and letting me have a say in how to get that going. And now we've got to continue that. And if we can keep the program going, then I think we'll be a playoff contender every year. I really believe that.
Yeah. And, Coach, you know, you bring up the point of how many you lost last year, and you look at the difference in the defense. Now, the defense has played well. Like you say, if we give them the ball, if we give them great field position, you got trouble on any team,
right,
especially a good team. But when they start out on our end of the field and they have to come on, or their end of the field and they have to come all the way down, march, you know, 60, 70, 80, 90 yards, the defense is going to stop them. It may be a big play and all in there, but defense is going to stop them. But one thing is different, Coach, from last year is how much meat we had up front, aggressive. They tied up a lot of blockers.
Well, people, we got kind of spoiled the last couple of years because we were so dominant up front. We had, you know, big Shendrika Smith, Mateo Elvine in there, Abram last year. You know, he's been out this year.
You got linebackers running around making tackles.
Absolutely. And before that, Trey Mason in the middle. We had some
we
had some beef in the middle, and we had some really physical kids, and it spoiled us a little bit. And this year we had to rebuild on that D-line a little bit.
Yeah.
But I'm proud of the kids. I think they played hard. I think at times we played really well on defense this year, and I think at other times we haven't. But I think that's part of having new guys out there, and I'm proud of their effort. You know, we're never satisfied and say, hey, that's good enough. But you know, you want to find those positives and say, look, you guys are playing hard. I'm proud of you. Let's keep working. Keep our hand to the grindstone.
Yeah, and build every week, because this is the part of the season that matters. And like you say, Coach, we've got to encourage as a community, as parents, as Raider fans, as Raider Nation, so to speak. Coach, like you're trying to encourage these kids, you've got to step up. You've got to take up the slack. If your brother's out, if the guy next to you is out, if you got to step up and be the guy that fills that position, you got to do it. You got to find it within yourself to be that physically and mentally tough.
Yeah, we try and get, you know, we tell them, we say, somebody needs to be that guy that's going to say, you know what, follow me. I'll find a way. Mm-hmm. If you follow me, I'll get it done, and we'll all get to the promised land.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's hard every year to find those guys.
Mm-hmm.
It's different every year on that team to find that guy that says, get behind me, get on my back, and we're going to cross the goal line.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of what we're looking for a little bit this year. But, again, you know, we teach these kids football's a lot like life. You know, sometimes life is great. Sometimes life isn't so great. But how you respond to those situations is going to determine the amount of success you have in life. If when things get hard, you quit, or you hang your head, or you start pouting, just like football, just like life, it's going to be rough.
It's going to be real rough.
But when things get hard, if you get harder,
then
that's when you're going to have some success.
Yeah.
And that's why I love football, because you know, you want to teach kids these lessons, because I mean, 99.9% of the kids we coach will never play football again after high school.
Right.
They never. That's just a fact.
Yep.
You know, very few of them are going to go on to the next level, and very few of them are going to go on, even fewer than that are going to go on to that final level.
Right.
But if they can learn these lessons about personal responsibility, doing my job, being a leader, you know, being tough, dealing with difficult situations with the right attitude, without making excuses, without saying it's somebody else's fault, without pointing the finger, if we can do those things, then I think we'll be successful. And I think wins will take care of themselves.
Well, Coach, we're looking at ups and lead a roll in here, and we're going to kick off about 7:30 Friday night right here at the Shoe. We want everybody to turn out and to be a part of the game. The ups and leave, or what is worth, is what, 2-2 in the region? They have one loss or two losses?
They just have two. Yeah, they lost.
Yeah, they have two.
Up to Mary Persons and Howard.
Yeah. Right. They fell to Howard by 1 point, mm-hmm. which was a surprise. Could be an encouraging. Could be some factors such as injury involved.
Howard's
there.
A team that's getting better every year, and Barney Hester has them coached up. So,
yeah. You know, they are getting better every year.
Yeah, we were fortunate to beat them the way we did this year at our place.
Yeah.
But we played really well that game.
So we're just looking this week, Coach, I'm sure not to spot any points early on.
I hope not.
And try to control the ball more.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So turn out, ladies and gentlemen, be a part of the exciting West Lawrence Raider football. We'll see you Friday night.
At Morris Bank, we understand that your personal finances and banking experiences can be stressful. We also know that it doesn't have to be that way. That's why for over 60 years, we've dedicated ourselves to providing common sense banking to people just like you.
Even when I started working here, there was a definite vibe that you felt when you walked in the door, from the music that you're always going to hear playing to the hello, good to see you, welcome, how can we help you? You know, it's just a different experience when you bank here.
We work hard to combine the latest online mobile technology and top-notch customer service that allows us to do just that.
Realize our customers have choices, but what sets us apart is the personal service that we provide that they may not receive at larger institutions. We like to make you feel at home, and we like to make the process as easy as possible when you're banking with us.
But we're not focused on helping just our customers. We are equally dedicated to supporting the community we are a part of. Just this year alone, we've logged thousands of community service hours and provided significant financial support to the communities we serve.
Something that sets us apart at Morris Bank is what we give back to the communities in which we serve. And as the communities continue to grow, that brings more business and more industry into the area. And it's just this circle effect of giving back and receiving what the community can offer.
We want to make sure you have the best banking experience possible. Come see us or give us a call to find out what makes Morris Bank different, because we're banking on you.